Praise the Lord, my dear friends. Today, let us reflect together on the readings that are given to us for the 30th Sunday of the Ordinary Time. Today's first reading, taken from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 31, verses 7 to 9, we have the promise of the Lord regarding the restoration of the people of the Jewish nation after the Babylonian captivity. When the people were carried away by the Babylonian Empire, we know they were taken far from the temple of the Lord. They were taken far away from the presence of the Lord. And now the Lord is telling them to sing aloud and to rejoice because He was planning to bring them back. Coming back to the presence of the Lord is indeed a great reason to rejoice and to celebrate. Do we feel that at times we too are carried away from the presence of the Lord? If yes, this passage is for us as well. While promising them the restoration, the Lord particularly mentions few categories of people. He tells them that He would lead the blind, the lame, and the pregnant. We know these categories are individuals, those who require help from others. And look at a blind person. He's able to walk, but then not clear of the target where he should go. He's not able to see ahead where he should go. At times, do we find ourselves in this way? We are able to do whatever we can, but then we really do not know what we should do in order to get that presence of the Lord back in our life. We try different things, we go to different places, we try different methods, but somehow the presence of the Lord which we had enjoyed earlier is not coming back to our life. We are willing to do, but then do not know where to go. Look at the second category, the lame. When we are spiritually lame, we make a lot of effort to walk ahead. We know where to go. We are able to see it. We want to achieve it. But then somehow we are not able to make it. We get tired so fast. We feel that the effort that we make is not bearing fruit and so on. And now, when the Lord speaks about restoration, He says He will lead them along the brooks. Brooks would mean a source of refreshment, right? The lame people, when they walk, you know, they get tired very quickly. They require refreshment. And the Lord says He will lead them by the brooks. And then look at the blind people. See, they are able to walk. They can walk fast maybe, but then they are not sure if the way they take is really the right one. And especially if there is a lot of turnings and twists in the path, they may stumble. And therefore the Lord says, I will lead them by a straight path. Look at this Lord. The Lord knows exactly the kind of weaknesses that a person is going through, and He is able to lead them into His presence by keeping in mind the weaknesses that person is going through. And that is why in Psalm 32 verse 8 we have, I will instruct you and teach you the way you should go, and I will counsel you with my eye upon you. Look at this Lord. He is willing to counsel everyone with His eye upon that individual. So the Lord knows what exactly is the problem that person is going through. The Lord knows the struggle that person was going through. And so the Lord is not going to give a general solution to everyone, to be followed by everyone. The Lord knows individually every single person and the struggle that person is going through. And so He is willing to counsel each one according to His own requirement. All what we need to do is to go to His presence in weeping. And that is why in verse 9, chapter 31, verse 9, the Lord says, in weeping they shall come, but with consolation I will lead them back. All what we need to do is to surrender ourselves completely in tears before the Lord. He will restore us back. And at times we may feel, no, we are not really worthy for this. We might feel that we have gone a little too far from the Lord now. It's not really easy. Yeah, it may be true. We are not really worthy. But it's not because we are worthy that the Lord wants to restore us. But what He says in chapter 31, verse 3, I have loved you with an everlasting love, and therefore I have continued my faithfulness to you. Not because we are worthy, but because the Lord has loved us with an everlasting love, and therefore He has continued to be faithful to us. And look at the second reading. It says that every high priest is chosen by the Lord to act on behalf of man. And we know Jesus is our high priest. When we go in tears before the Lord, before Jesus, before the Blessed Sacrament, The Lord will restore us in consolation. Whatever may be our present situation, now at this moment, it does not matter. If we are willing to go before Him in tears and accept the teaching and the instruction that He would give us by keeping His eye upon us, He will restore us back to the presence of the Lord. And look at the gospel. What do we see here? We see in Mark 10 verses 46 to 52, the blind man Bartimaeus shouting aloud, crying out, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." Everyone in the crowd was telling him to keep silence, but he kept crying out, and the Lord called him and healed him. The whole world may be presenting us with reasons why we cannot enjoy the presence of God, why it is not worth spending time begging for the mercy and the love and care of the Lord. But like Bartimaeus, when we are willing to surrender ourselves totally to the mercy of the Lord and to cry out, the Lord will restore us. Because He is a God with an everlasting love. And that is the reason for His faithfulness. And because of this faithfulness, He is willing to teach us, instruct us, and counsel us with His eye upon us. Why should we wait? Let us go back to the Lord and be completely restored in His presence. May God bless each one of us.